Ireland and England here at the finals hall at the Royal Artillery Barracks as we kick off the first event of the ISSF London Prepares Pre-Olympic World Cup 10-meter Air Rifle Women. Over 800 athletes representing 96 countries have gathered here under the cold London skies to this enormous venue where the newly installed ranges for rifle, pistol, and shotgun will be tried out for the next 10 days. The pressure for the gold, silver, and bronze medals is hanging in the air as the excitement of the games is only months away. As I said before, we're starting off a 10-meter air rifle woman here in the finals hall, and it's with pleasure that I have Great Britain's rifle shooter, Jennifer Korsh, here with me. Welcome, Jenny, and thanks for joining us.
Thank you very much for having me.
It's quite an amazing venue, I'd have to say.
It's an incredible venue, considering it's only just a few months they took to build it.
It was about 2 months, no?
It was not long, yeah.
Not long at all. And you must feel pretty proud. You're representing the British team as well and having the Olympics being held here.
It's an amazing feeling. It's almost like our home Olympics this week. We've got spectators. We've got family who can come and watch. It's great.
Is it? Yeah. And today, tell me a little bit about qualifications today. How is that? You know, I think a lot of people that have traveled here are coming from very warm countries, and they're coming here now to London where it's really, really cold.
From my point of view, even training in the UK over the winter where it has been bitter, it was cold on the range today. There's no heating on the 10-meter range, so you come expecting an indoor match, and it's cold.
Even with all of the jacket and the pants and everything that you wear, you still felt pretty cold.
Yeah, it was still bitterly cold, and also you're limited on the thickness of clothing you can wear underneath, so you can only wear so many thermal layers.
Dear Lord, poor thing. Representing Austria. Just a second, I'll introduce our finalists today. We had a 10-way final after qualifications to get into this final today. And there she is, in eighth place, coming with 397 points, representing Austria. We have Lisa Ungerank. She's 19 years old. She placed 29th during the World Cup in Munich last year, and she also placed 41st in Fort Benning last year during the World Cup.
So a young shooter, she's got a lot of good experience now. She's made some big finals.
Sorry there. I'm going to go back now and say in fifth place, coming with 397 points. Here we have Stina Nielsen. Sonja is 3 times world champion. And we have in fourth place, coming with 398 points, representing the Russian Federation, Daria Dovina. She's 27 years old. She was in 26th place during the World Cup in Fort Benning in 2010, and she also was in 27th place in Munich in 2009. Currently ranked number one in the world and current world champion. And in second place, coming with 398 points, representing Germany, we have Sonja Pfeilschifter. She's 41 years old. She's a 2-time world champion and a 1-time junior world champion. She won the bronze medal during the world championships in 2002. And then we have in first place, coming in with 400 points, equaling her own world record that she set, Siling. She represents the People's Republic of China, and she's 22 years old. She won the gold medal during the World Championships in Munich in 2010, and she also won the gold medal during the World Cup final in 2011. 2 minutes. So these are our finalists today, Jenny. Tell me what you think.
400 in tough conditions like it was today is an incredible shoot. So it'll be interesting to see how she copes in the final.
She's a tough one.
Particularly facing Sonja Pfeilschifter, again, another experienced shooter with age on her side.
She's got the age experience. She is a veteran shooter, and she's a left-handed shooter. So how do you think that affects, I mean, you're basically, you are face-to-face.
You're eyeballing each other. Yeah. So it'll be interesting how they cope, whether they just focus down their lane or whether they look at each other and play mind game.
That's true. And I believe it was Fort Benning that she became sick in, was it last year? And she fought it out.
She still went on
she
to
went on.
Win, was it?
She won the gold, yeah. So that just goes to show.
I mean, shooting in conditions like today shows how tough she is. Mm-hmm. Everyone was struggling out there today, so to come out with a 400 is incredible.
And then, you know, there were a lot of veteran shooters also shooting during the qualifications. And we end up having some really young girls that are entering in today's final.
Is it last five or below 22?
I believe so. Let's see here. Let's see, we have...
I mean, we've got some who are still just juniors to make such a big final in the year of the Olympics.
An 18-year-old shooter, 20-year-old shooter, you know, they're very 19, very, very young.
It'll be interesting to see how they cope under the pressure of such a big final.
That's
in
true.
Such a big venue, the finals hall is huge.
It's enormous. It's absolutely enormous. And, you know, it, like you said before, it is gorgeous here. They have done a lot of work to prepare for this, and you can see that their hard work has paid off. This is a good time to get used to your surroundings. If you know that you have a quota place into the games,
yeah.
To
learn the venue,
yeah.
Make most of the experience of having spectators, learn the way around the range.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, hopefully it'll be a bit warmer for the Olympics being in August.
Let's hope so. I have no idea. Every time that I've been to England, it's been cold. It doesn't matter if it's summer
but
or...
But did you know we're in a drought at the moment? England is in a drought and there's hose pipe ban. Considering it's just rained for the last 3 days.
Very interesting, to say the least. So the pressure is on. As you can see, we do have spectators that come here to watch this first event. And we're going to move on now to the first competition shot.
Attention. 3, 2,
all right,
one,
let's take a look now
five.
At Ungerank and Masimovic.
Two of our younger shooters in 7th, 8th place, is that?
That's right, after a 10-way shoot-off to get into the final today.
That was a tough shoot-off.
I'm sure it was.
And there was two tie shoots after the shoot-off had finished.
You can see, you know, these they're very high scores.
I mean, Lisa shot 2 10.6s during her two tie shoots during the shoot-off. So to show that nerve is good going. And a 10.4 start.
That's really, really great.
For her age and experience.
And they have 75 seconds to shoot.
Yeah.
10.6 to start for Maximovic is fantastic. Really great way for both of these women to start off. That must give them a little bit of confidence.
Yeah. I think once you've got that first shot, you can almost breathe easy.
Stop.
All right, let's take a look at the standings now after shot one. We have Yi in first place still after shooting a 10.5. We have Pfeilschifter now down by 1.7 tenths of a point after shooting a 10.8. Ronska shooting a 10.4. She's still in third place. Vodvina in fourth place after shooting a 10.3. A 10.3 also for Nielsen, Westerheim a 10.0, an 8.6 for Masimovic. We have a 10.6, sorry, and a 10.4 for Ungerank.
It's going to be a very close final by the look of it. It will be interesting to see if Yi can hold on to a 2-point lead.
So Yi, really, you know, she's only dropped, 3 tenths of a point after that first shot. She is going up against an amazing, amazing woman, Pfeilschifter, who just, she can come up from behind and grab
I've
it.
I've seen her win many finals at European Championships. She's won the last two, so.
We're moving on now to shot two. Let's take a look at Westerheim and Nielsen. Stina Nielsen, she is a new up-and-coming strong shooter. We're seeing her.
And she's incredibly good at 3P as well.
Really?
She's made a few finals at that.
It is also interesting to see the speed of taking the shot.
Yeah.
You know, in different styles of these shooters.
I mean, you'll see the more experienced shooters like Pfeilschifter take her time. She's almost inevitably the last person to fire, whereas some of the others, as soon as they say start, they pull the trigger.
10.3 for Nielsen and a
10.7. A very good
10.7
there.
Very nice for Westerheim. This is amazing, seeing faces that I've never seen before in a final. And
they're
still
just putting in the tens.
They
yeah.
sure are.
And here's the experience.
Experience of Pfeilschifter. She is generally the last one to shoot.
But then there's no hurry. You've got those 75 seconds.
But 75 seconds to a spectator sometimes seems like a lifetime. And you think, oh, my gosh, please shoot. You're going to run out of time, you know?
Although we do now have the clocks on the side of the wall, so you can see what time.
Would you look at that?
Not out of habit, but if I needed to.
Okay. Ten point three for Pfeilschifter. Stop. And let's take a look at the standings. Okay, so we've got Yi still in first place. After shooting a 10.6, she now has got regained her 2.0 advantage over Pfeilschifter, who shot a 10.3. Rowanska, who shot a 9.4, is also we've got Vidovina with a 10.8. Nielsen a 10.3, Westerheim 10.7, Maximovic a 9.0, and Ungerank a 10.6. So let's take a look here at the standings. Vidovina is tied up
after that shot.
It certainly has. 10.8 will definitely move you up the scoreboard, and she's now tied up with Pfeilschifter, which must be really strange for Pfeilschifter to hear a name that maybe she hasn't heard so much.
I think so. Yeah. I wonder how much notice they actually take of the commentary, because having the commentary for the spectators is now difficult not to know how close you are.
Exactly.
3, 2, 1, start.
It's only so much the earplugs can block out.
Vidovina and Ronska. A 10.3 for Ronska. And just waiting now for Vidovina. A 9.9. Pfeilschifter. She was not pleased with that 10.3. You know, she can shoot a 10.6 sometimes, and you see the look on her face, and she seems like she's not very happy with that as well.
I have to see how she gets on. It's not, this camera view really shows them you what they think of that shot.
Exactly.
You can't hide from that. The camera.
No, you can't.
There we go.
10.6. That's going to get her place in second place once again.
Round three, the scores. Firing point one, E.
We have Yi, who shot a 10.5, still holding on to first place, but just with a 1/10 of a disadvantage, she lost this 1/10 of an advantage over Pfeilschifter, after Pfeilschifter has shot a 10.6. Ronska a 10.3, Vidovina a 9.9, Nielsen a 9.5, Westerheim a 10.3, Maximovic a 9.7, and Ungerank a 10.2. So we still have Yi in first place, Pfeilschifter in second place, 7/10 of a point behind. We've got Vidovina.
There's now a little gap going down to fourth.
That's right, and now, you know, just 1/10 of a point between third and fourth place.
And another 10 down to fifth.
That's right. So it's going to be tight, and like you said before, now that the shooters, they can hear where they are standing. You can see towards the end of the final that things get really, really unnerved.
The pressure piles on. Yeah. It's difficult to hold yourself in that little bubble when you can hear the commentary going on.
And there they are, our first and second place shooters right now. Pfeilschifter going up against Yi face to face.
3, 2, 1, start.
We can see their different styles, how Pfeilschifter will spend a long time before she even looks through the sights.
That's true. And usually, she's got quite an arch to her back.
She does.
You know?
She's got quite a high right elbow as well.
A 9.8. This could change things around like we
that
have known.
That must be a first nine of the day.
It probably was. It's now on to Pfeilschifter.
If she shoots a good 10 now, she'll have really closed up that gap.
She certainly will have. A
we go. 10.7. The experience is showing.
It certainly is, and things are going to change around. She didn't look terribly upset about that shot, which is great.
I can't say I would be either.
And in fact, Yi's still holding the first place after shooting a 9.8, but she only has a one-point advantage now over Pfeilschifter, who shot a 10.7.
That makes things much more interesting. 1 point is nothing in a final.
It's true.
2 points, you've got a bit of an advantage. 1 point, you can catch in a shot.
Ronska shot a 10.3. Vidovina a 10.6. Nielsen, 10.5. Westerheim, a beautiful 10.7. Maximovic, a 10.1. And Ungerank, a 9.8. Let's take a look now. What we've got only 0.8 of a point. That we have Vidovina behind Pfeilschifter. And Westerheim, after shooting that 10.7, is now 0.9 of a point behind Vidovina. So it's really
looking close at the top.
Certainly is looking close.
Could be an exciting last few shots in the final.
But you know, also something that we should keep in mind is that, you know, the Chinese team is a very strong team, and they've got some mental training that they do.
Yeah.
That even if Yi is going up against great veteran shooter Pfeilschifter, she still has that training.
And she's done it before. It's not her first final.
That's
she's
right.
Been in that first place. So she knows how to do it.
Okay, we are now at the halfway mark.
It's interesting to see some wooden rifles still out there. There's not many of them left now with the aluminium ones.
Let's see now how this goes for Vidovina, if she can keep on shooting in the high tens. That's a 9.5. That's not going to help her. No. And you can see that she is disappointed by that shot.
Back to Pfeilschifter.
Really just waiting for the very right second for her to shoot.
You can see that very last second, it just sits dead still.
It's
good, solid shooting.
It's not going to change anything between the standings of the two of them, because also Yi has shot a 10.5. So we still have 1 point that's going to be separating the two women. We have Rowanska, who shot a 10.6, Vidovina a 9.5, Nielsen a 9.9, Westerheim a 10.4, Maximovic a 10.6, and Ungerank a 10.5. So we still have Yi first place at 1 point over Pfeilschifter, Vidovina in third place right now, and Westerheim is tied up now.
And fifth place is just 0.1 away. It's very close for that bronze medal at the moment.
It certainly is. You know, and it's very close for the gold medal as well between the two of them. It's maybe a little bit of a different game for bronze because they are younger shooters and don't have a whole lot of experience coming into World Cups for the first time. So things are changing around and making it very interesting for the spectators. And I'm sure for the shooters themselves.
It makes you wonder as well how much the cold is starting to affect them. They've been in here a few minutes now.
Mm-hmm.
The cold will starting to bite like it was in the match.
Right.
You can see some woolly hats out there. Just a couple today.
Yeah, but you need them.
You do.
Definitely do. Just looking at you all wrapped up in one letter after another. Okay, let's take a look now at Westerheim. She is tied up for third place. And she knows where she's standing right now. Pressure is on as we move on to shot six.
But five good tens to start.
I know, really just unbelievable shooting. It'll be interesting to know what's going through her mind right now.
Hopefully she'll be just concentrating on a shot process.
A 10.0.
We'll just have to wait to see what the others around her do.
That's right. She doesn't look very happy. I'm sure she's wishing it was up in the high tens.
It's always disappointing when it doesn't flash on the screen.
Yeah.
And it needs to be a 10.2 or above to do that.
Pfeilschifter shooting a 10.5.
Stop. Round six, the scores.
Caught up point one there.
We have Yi who shot a 10.4, Pfeilschifter a 10.5. So now there's only 9 tenths of a point separating the two women.
Still tied for third.
Ron's got a 10.7. Vidovina a 10.6. Nielsen shot a 10.1. Westerheim a 10.0. Maximovic a 10.5. And Ungerank a perfect 10.9. That moved her right up the scoreboard. We have Yi, like I said, still holding on to first place. Pfeilschifter, it's tied up. It's not tied up, it's in second place. Vidovina and Ronska are tied up for third. 10.9 from Ungerank is just an amazing thing to do.
There's just 0.6 between those four shooters going for bronze at the moment.
There could be maybe even a shoot-off. It could go into some type of a shoot-off after. You never know. But now, with the new rules, we just shoot off for the medals.
Yeah.
Moving on now to shot seven.
Just four shots to go, is it now?
Yes, just four shots to go, and 9 tenths of a point separating
attention
first from second place.
Three, two, one,
let's take a look and focus in on Yi. This is when oftentimes we can see that Sonja Pfeilschifter, she really puts the pressure on.
You can see that she just stares. For
yes.
The first few seconds, she looks across before she looks down the sight. Whereas Yi, on the other hand, has a different technique and is straight into the aim. You see her finding a balance.
10.4. And now back on to Pfeilschifter.
Interesting hand position.
It really is.
With her finger up the side. You don't see many people shooting like that.
A 10.6.
Stop.
She looks happy with that?
She does, yep. Look at her just staring at her opponent. I'd be afraid.
Run away.
With Yi shooting that 10.4 and Pfeilschifter 10.6, there's now only 7 tenths of a point separating first from second place. We have the tie for third is now broken. Vidovina is holding a third place by herself. But she's only holding on to that by 1 tenth of a point. Let me just go over the shots for shot seven. A 10.4 for Yi, Pfeilschifter 10.6, Ronska a 9.9, Vidovina a 10.2, Nielsen a 10.1, Westerheim a 9.6, Maximovic a 10.6, and Ungerank a 10.4. Unbelievable shooting right now.
It's definitely a two-way race at the moment. First and second, and then fighting it out for third.
You know, Pfeilschifter, being a left-handed shooter, she does have an advantage over being able to really stare into her.
She's used to facing her opponent.
Exactly.
Whereas a right-handed shooter, you're normally looking at someone's back. It's
right.
Different to be looking at someone's face.
Exactly.
But you've got to try and focus on your normal game.
Mm-hmm.
Focus on the process of shooting the shot. Not think about where you are,
right,
but what you and how you train back at home. Because you've shot a 10 a million times in training, there's no reason why it should be any different today.
Vidovina now, she's holding on to third place by 1 tenth of a point.
That's not going to help her.
That's not going to help at all, 9.4. Let's take a look now at Yi. She really has to shoot strong as a 10.2.
Not sure that'll be enough the way Pfeilschifter was shooting today.
You can't read her face though. Yi's face, you cannot read at all what she's thinking. So a 10.2 that was for Yi.
Not much in it.
Not too much, but one more tenth of a point. And
yep.
She's making the slow climb up.
Just those two shots to go now.
Two more shots. After shot eight, which he shot a 10.2, Pfeilschifter a 10.3, Ronska a 10.1, Vidovina a 9.4. Unfortunate 9.4 has changed her standings greatly. Nielsen a 10.2, Westerheim a 10.9, perfect shot there. Maximovic a 10.0, and Ungerank a 10.4. So we have Yi in first place by 6 tenths of a point over Pfeilschifter. Ungerank with that 10.9 has now moved up into third place.
Gives a 0.5 advantage now.
That's amazing with that 10.9. Yeah. It's amazing with those 10.9s will do, actually. Really has moved up the scoreboard and has taken over the bronze at the moment by 5 tenths of a point. It's still not a whole lot. You know, anything could happen in the last two shots.
But those little points can make all the difference.
For the next competition shot, load.
On to the ninth shot.
Attention. 3, 2,
Ungerank coming off.
A very tidy final so far, just
it
a 1.9
is.
And a 10.9 in there as well. One of the shooters trying to stay warm.
Bring a nice wool hat. You need it. It's cold in here.
It's just cold sitting here.
Yeah, I know. It really is.
On the range.
A 10.2. She's shaking her head at that. Back on now to Yi.
This one in the final, the points can make all the difference. In a match, you just need a 10.
That's right. A 10, a 9,
but
eight.
A 10.2 might not be good enough in a final. You're looking for 10 fives, 10 sixes plus.
A 10.4. It'd be interesting to know if she's feeling really the pressure now from Pfeilschifter. You know, it's not really overly visible to on her face, but 10.5.
Another 0.1.
They're
not
just
happy with
really
that one.
Making it. Wait the very last shot to find out who's going to be in first place. 10.4 for Yi. Still keeps her in first place, but only by half a point over Pfeilschifter, who shot a 10.5. We have Ungerank still holding on to third place. This is after shooting a 10.2.
She's got a bit more of a lead now.
She does. She's almost got a full point. We have Ronska, who shot a 9.8. And then we have Westerheim, who has shot a 9.4. Vidovina, who has unfortunately moved down the scoreboard after shooting a 9.0. Nielsen in seventh place after shooting a 10.2. And Maximovic in eighth place after shooting a 10.5. All right, would you put money down? Are you a betting girl?
I'd say Yi's got half a point, so it's hers to throw away at the moment.
Okay.
A nice solid 10 is all she needs, and Pfeilschifter can't catch her.
That's right.
But then anything can happen on the last shot.
That's
it's
true.
It's never over till the bullet's gone down the range.
Last shot of this first final here.
Will half point be enough?
Attention. 3, 2, 1. Start.
Here the two are. We have Pfeilschifter going up against Yi.
They'll be sticking to their normal process, hopefully treating it like any other shot. But it's not any other shot. It's the last shot in the final.
It's the last shot that can change everything. See the concentration.
Oh,
a 9.2. Look at she.
Now it's Pfeilschifter's to win.
Yeah. I'd have to say that Pfeilschifter has got it in the bag at this point.
All she needs is a 10.
Yeah.
Well, 9.8 would put it to a tie shoot. And with her experience.
You know, she's not looking at Yi, obviously. She's looking down her rifle, but
10.2. That'll do. That's all she needs.
She doesn't. Not quite sure she knew or not, but there's our winner, our gold medalist, Sonja Pfeilschifter. 9.5 for Ungerank.
Wins by just not runs by 0.1 in the end.
By 1/10 of a point. My goodness, there she is, our gold medalist, Germany's Sonja Pfeilschifter. She does it again. Always, it seems like, comes in from behind.
From that last shot.
In the last shot, she just she must train and train and train on that last shot.
Well, she's got that experience, and I think that last shot is when it really excels.
There we have it, gold medalist.
Oh, final she shot before.
Sonja Pfeilschifter finishing off with 503.0 points. Yi Siling finishing off with 502.5. And Lisa Ungerank coming up, stealing the third place with 500.3 points. Unbelievable.
Coming up from the shoot-off, that's
really
incredible,
that's
final.
Incredible.
And at such a young age as well. And she looks very pleased
she
about it.
She does look very, very pleased about this, and she really definitely deserves that, you know, coming in eighth place with 397 points after a 10-way shoot-off and winning the bronze medal. Only 19 years old and never entering into a final round of a World Cup
before. Is that really her first final?
Yeah, it is.
Wow.
Yep.
Coming in eighth place.
Coming in eighth place after the 10-way shoot-off. And
to come away with a medal.
Yeah, coming away with a medal. Really great shooting there. We have it again. Gold medalist Sonja Pfeilschifter. You can tell that she's very pleased about this gold as well as she should be. Let's just see if I can take a look and find our silver medalist. And there she is, Yi Siling, who had an unfortunate last shot, moved her down into silver place on the second highest step of the podium. You can tell that she was really upset about that last shot, but she's carrying on,
yep.
I'm sure.
I'm sure she'll come back.
In our
we'll
bronze
have to see how this bodes for the Olympics
that's
now, because
right.
That's the big one that everyone wants.
That's right. And there's our bronze medalist, first time bronze medalist, World Cup bronze medalist, 19-year-old Lisa Ungerank from Austria. Well, Jenny, listen, I want to thank you so much for sitting next to me in this cold, cold venue.
It's been a pleasure. It's a bit chilly here.
I know you said you've never commentated before, but God, you did a great job. And
thank
I
you.
Just wish you the very best with future competitions. And good luck to you.
And it's lovely to welcome you all here to London.
Thank you.
Presented by Franz Schreiber, the Secretary General, ISSF. The bronze medalist, representing Austria, Lisa Ungerank. The silver medalist, representing the People's Republic of China, Siling. Gold medalist representing Germany, Sonja Pfeilschifter. Germany.
Ladies and gentlemen, please acknowledge our women's 10-meter air rifle medalists.